Right now, look who's joined us in the studio. It's Kiell, Smith-Bynoe, Jill Scott and Jamie Redknapp. Hey. Thanks for joining us.
Jill and Jamie, we'll be chatting to you very, very soon. But Kiell, plenty of viewers will know you as Mike from Ghosts. And now you are the host of Sewing Bee, so congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
But this isn't your first rodeo, is it? We first saw you as a contestant on the show, and then you did host the Christmas special.
Yes.
So does this mean you're a whiz with a needle and thread?
I could lie and say yeah, but I don't know. I wouldn't know what I'm doing. I was quite surprised that they asked me to present, mainly because I don't think I was any good when I was a contestant. But they got me back, and I started causing havoc in the haberdashery. And see, I know that's one word I know.
It's a good
nice, yeah.
See, if you say the words, they think you know what you're talking about.
I don't know. I think that clip gave it away that you can't say. That wasn't looking too good. I don't think, bro. Now, Vic did mention that you hosted the celeb special. How has this one kind of been different for
you? Well, we shot it all at the same time. But it was different because working with the celebrity guests, they are sort of doing it for a bit of fun. Whereas the contestants are really passionate about this. And it's something that they've always wanted to do. It's a massive deal for them to even be on the show. So to actually like be part of the competition, be in with the chance of winning is huge for them. Mm. So you've got to take it you've got to treat it a little bit differently.
Yeah.
You've been a contestant, so you know the sort of pressure that they're under.
Yes.
What do you feel like your role is?
I try to give support. But quite often, like, you'll be thrown in to go and talk to them and they've got sort of 5 minutes left and they need half an hour to get their thing finished. So someone's under, like, a lot of pressure. Yeah. And, of course, it gets quite emotional because, like, they really care about this. So at times, people are crying or having, like, a really tough time because they know they're not going to finish in time. And it's the difference between them staying in the competition or going.
Yeah. Well, let's take a look at you in action celebrating the 10th series with some cocktails.
You have 1 hour left.
This gathering will hopefully make it a lovely puff.
I'm just getting the skirt fastened to the top.
Oh, my God.
I've been making stuff too, right?
Is that what you've been making?
Yeah.
This whole time?
It's only taken me 4 hours.
4 hours?
Yeah.
You've done really well.
Thank you.
I am pleased with my buttonholes. Hopefully, I can get it done.
Once you get the goatees in and then do a hem, it's possible.
So, as you have half an hour.
Where did those drinks go?
I've got to ask you both, Jamie and Jill, whilst you're here. You both like your threads, always immaculately dressed when we're watching you. I just think you'd fancy your chances on Great British Sewing Bee.
I'd be terrible.
Yeah?
I actually would. You'd be all right.
Yeah.
What, so-and-so? Or good? sorry, mate. It's
That's terrible.
no, you got it at the end of the
It landed just
Thank
now,
you, mate. Okay. Thank you.
Not bad.
You're quite domesticated.
No, I'm really not. No. I'm actually not, no. I would be terrible. Hands down, terrible.
And that pressure, though.
Yeah.
It's such a fine detail you'll get right.
Yeah. It's the timing that's the most bit of pressure is knowing that you've only got a certain amount of time left. And knowing how long it takes to do things.
Yeah, I'm not sure I'll be good at that one.
Yeah. Well, let's talk about the judges as well. So you've got Esme Young, Patrick Grant, they're amazing. Yeah. However, we do have to point out, Esme wasn't sure who you were to begin with.
I'm not sure she does now.
Oh, God.
I think she knew me from being on the show before, but I don't think she'd got the time to watch anything that I'd done because she's busy. She's still teaching. She still lectures and also being a judge and she writes and all of those things. She's always going around the world doing sort of like exhibitions and things like that. So she's busy, too busy to know who I was. She's just like, well done.
Nice, yeah. Has she seen you on stage yet, though? Because you're currently starring, aren't you, in the Government Inspector?
Yes, that's
right. What can people like expect from that?
So it's a farce, it's fast-paced, it's silly, it's a comedy, it's really fun. Myself, Dan Skinner, Martha Howe Douglas are the leads in it and we just get to be really... I haven't seen this
yet. There you are, it's a nice little clip for you.
Yeah.
You've got moves in that, Kiell.
Mm.
Yeah, I brought in some of my own moves for that.
Of course.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it's really fun and we're doing that up until the 15th of June in the Marylebone Theatre.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Fun fact, everyone, on the floor. Kiell actually came up with the iconic phrase, platy jubes.
That's true.
That was you.
For
the Platinum Jubilee in 2022.
Nice.
Where did this come from? Have you got a phrase for the sewing bee?
I mean, it's always, you know, when you've done the first album, everyone's not sure about the second. And platy jubes is a hit. But, I mean, I'd call it sewy bobs if we had
sewy
to have...
Bobs.
Yeah.
Sewy bobs.
It's quicker than saying a Great British Sewing Bee, and I had to say that quite a lot.
It's hard to say, isn't it? I keep saying Showing Bee.
Right, yeah.
Showing Bee, and I say, yeah, that's going to be
my
right favour.
Or my mum says Spelling Bee.
Yeah, there we go.
Which is a different show.
Different thing.
Yeah, completely different thing.
We'll stick with that. Thank you very much, Kiell. The 10th series are The Great British Sewing Bee, or Sewy Bobs, as Kiell likes to call it. Starts next Tuesday at 9 o'clock on BBC One, and it will, of course, be on iPlayer too.
As is the brilliantly funny comedy Ghost, starring Kiell. So, like Esme, you can catch up on it.
Okay, also hitting the small screen next Tuesday is the return of A League of Their Own. And it's this time, it's the comedy game show has gone on a Mexican road trip.
And as ever, there are a series of challenges for Jill and Jamie and their teammates. And you can't go to Mexico without a bit of lucha libre.
Lucha libre.
Also known as Mexican wrestling.
Jill, imagine it's Serena Wiegman when she left you out of the team.
She didn't do that.
She did in the final.
Yeah. Like, fighting.
Weren't you on the bench for the final?
Get angry, you bench warmer. Come on.
Yes, have some of that, Serena. Don't you ever leave me out again.
Go on, Jill. Get angry, Jill.
Sorry, Jill. I was trying to get you ready.
Yeah, get ready for it.
Yeah.
In the end.
Jamie, I've got to say, there's a common theme kind of running throughout this series. I noticed that you sent Jill in there to take all the hits on this occasion. What's that about?
Tougher than me.
That what it is? This comes down to that.
No, do you know, I didn't help my reputation. I hurt my back before I went.
Oh,
and
not again,
the one, mate, I know, but it doesn't help the rep, does it? But genuinely, I was in bits. And then we had to do wrestling. But Micah was there as well. You know what Micah's like? El Grande. That was what he wanted his nickname to be. You can imagine, can't you? There he is. But we had some fun. My role in the end was just designing the outfit. So we had Laliona, which is the lioness, obviously.
Nice.
Maisie was...
Oh, I can't even remember.
I can't remember. Something to do with her hair, I think. And then Big Meeks was La Sonrisa, which is the smile. There but he go. Wanted El Grande.
Yeah. What do you fancied yourself on the sewing bee? Designing the outfits as well, then?
Exactly, mate. Gosh. Yeah, yeah. But that's the magic of TV, I think.
That is.
You know what's weird, though? You were okay when we went for the tequila challenges, weren't you?
I was fine with that.
Oh, yeah.
I'll come back. Yeah. The back started to feel a little bit better after that. Yeah, I was like, wait, yeah, a couple of those. That's what I probably should have done before the wrestling. I'd have been doing all the top of the air.
Oh, Jill, what was Mexico like? Like, had you been before?
So I'd been to Cancun just on holiday, but this was amazing, wasn't it? And the things that we got to do, I was going to say we played football in front of a lot of people, but we should be used to that a little bit. But we did baseball, scuba diving, just all kinds of different things. But it was so fun. We had such a laugh, and I think to think this is work.
Beautiful country as well, wasn't
it?
I'd never been before. And it was so nice to go there, and the food, the way the people were, they were so nice and friendly. It was a really good trip. Nice.
Yeah.
And what was Jamie like as a travelling partner?
He was good, actually. I think when we speak about playing football, people say, do you miss it? And you do a little bit, but I really miss the banter. So on them trips, you're on the minibus a lot, and we had a lot of laughs. And some of it, I didn't think they would keep in, but they actually have, so yeah, I'm a bit scared.
They're always going to keep it in, Jill.
I know, but I'm a bit scared now for people to see it, because I was like, yeah, they edit it and stuff like that, but they have kept some bits in.
You take on a lot of challenges on this show, and in one particular episode, you find yourself in deep water, Jill, taking photos of sea lions. I hear you're not the biggest fan of the water anyway.
No.
Again, Jamie looks like he's having just a lovely day out when we sit. Sat on the boat with his tequila, mate, basically. Oh. But was it scary?
Yeah, well, for me, Micah and Mo, we don't like water. You actually pulled this one out the bag. He was good at scuba diving. Obviously, he goes on these lovely holidays where he gets to do that, don't you?
Well, I didn't have a lot to beat. Micah can hardly swim. He wasn't getting in, was he, Mo?
He wasn't.
And you weren't too keen either. So I looked like Hasselhoff by the end of it.
Yeah.
And but no, it was one of those moments that, you know, TV just went wrong. Everything we tried to do, three boats broke down.
Yeah.
Where we were meant to get to this sea lion colony, where they all were,
yeah,
we couldn't make it because the boat didn't have enough petrol. So we ended up going to this like budget place where there was a few. Well, I wasn't actually sure. They said they were sea lions. I think they were more seals, or they might have been dressed up people as sea lions, you know, one of those.
Yeah.
And I've gone in there and I've managed to get a couple of photos. Yeah, it wasn't our greatest achievement, but we made the most of it, didn't we?
No, you actually couldn't write that day. He is right. Every boat we got on did end up breaking. And they said we're going to the best place in Mexico. And, it was
terrible. They were on appearance money, those guys. They probably just said, if people come along, just have a photo. No, it wasn't perfect.
It's just so much fun. Jill, you are a seasoned team captain at this point. But when you first retired from football, did you ever imagine life on a comedy game show?
No, never. I think I've I've always liked that part of football, though, like being part of a team, having the banter and stuff like that. So, yeah, I've really enjoyed that. But I do have to pinch myself that I'm on a league of their own, obviously, with these guys. But they've been so great. Ramesh is an absolute fantastic horse. So, yeah, I feel at home, really.
Yeah, it's been great.
And, Jamie, we were talking about it a little earlier. Men's football. Euros coming up.
Excited.
Looking forward to it.
I am. We've got a great chance.
Yeah.
You never know. We've obviously come so close, but I do feel we've got players that are in such great form, like Foden and Bellingham and what he's achieved this year at Real Madrid. I mean, you know, Jake, it's been unbelievable. So, fingers crossed, we can have a right go this year. Defensively, I worry a little bit, but hopefully Gareth can find the sort of right system, the right way of playing just to help us, because going forward, we should be a joy to watch.
Yeah.
Exciting.
And Joe, the Lionesses flying as well in qualifying at the minute. They've got to be huge favourites going into the Championships if they get there.
They've got some big games coming up against France. I've just got my tickets for St James's Park, Newcastle. I am a Sunderland fan, so, yeah. But I'm going to watch the Lionesses and hopefully they can get that win. But doing great as always. Yeah.
Brilliant.
Well, thank you so much. And A League of Their Own, The Mexican Road Trip, is out next Tuesday at 9 o'clock on Sky Max. And now both shows are on at the same time. So thank goodness for catch up.
We've got time for another message here. Wendy says, please give a shout out to my sister-in-law, Sally. She does a fabulous job as nurse practitioner in Hastings. Well done, Sally. All right, Vic, it's been an absolute pleasure, got to say. Next time you're going to be on, we'll be doing the Radio 1 weekend from Luton, won't
we? I will be, yeah. It's going to be huge, loads of big names. We've got Ray on the Saturday, Coldplay on the Sunday, and on Friday I'm actually going to be dialing into the One Show.
Good.
With one of the stars hitting the stage that night, Ella Henderson.
We cannot wait for that. Well, thanks all our guests tonight, to Jamie, Jill, to Kiell, and of course to Matt.
Lauren and Roman will be here tomorrow, and they'll be joined by Dara O'Brien and Hollywood stars Chris Hemsworth and Anya Taylor-Joy. Can't wait for that.
Yeah, good evening.
A lovely evening. We'll see you next time.
Good night.
Bye.